Is your home overrun with toys? Does your entire house seem like one big playroom for the kids? Well, if that's true, you're in luck because today we're going to talk about tackling the toy situation here on Get Organized with Jody. Hi, I'm Jody Granok. I'm a certified professional organizer with over 15 years in the field. And with the upcoming holiday season, it is definitely time to talk about tackling the toy situation so that we can make sure that we store our toys in an organized way. There are so many different toys to talk about that we've broken this into a three-part video series. So today we're on part one of tackling the toy situation. We're going to focus on storage solutions for specific toys because if you can keep your toys in an organized manner, it's going to help you identify where the toys are and be able to identify when you've outgrown these toys or when your children have outgrown these toys and are ready to swap them out for something else. The first toy storage solution I want to talk about are toy boxes. This was a very dangerous thing in my house growing up. Toy boxes are really not meant for toys. They're terrible for keeping toys organized. Not only because of the safety issue of getting the lid slamming down on little hands or feet or heads, goodness gracious, but offers very poor protection for the actual toys, and it becomes a dumping ground where everything is a cluttered mess and usually creates a lot of broken, lost, or damaged toys. Now, I'm not saying that you have to throw your toy box away because repurposing can be a wonderful solution. So instead, you can store extra blankets or towels in a toy box, or perhaps off-season clothes like sweatshirts or jackets. But let's put toys into other systems, starting with this. An open toy bin system is a much better idea if you're trying to replace your old toy box, because you could see all the items inside each bin. And of course, they come in a variety of sizes. And you can also get toy bins like this in different colors. This one uses primary colors for the most part. And what you need to do is sort toys based on how much you have of a certain type of item. Now, if you're trying to figure out how to sort and group like-minded items, you might want to refer back to our video on getting organized. Once you have your toys sorted into different bins, it's really important to add labels. Now, labels don't have to be words, especially if your children are not of reading age yet. You can make a picture of the certain type of toy by cutting something out from a magazine or printing something off your computer. You can even take a picture of the contents of the bin and print that out as your label so that even a 1 or 2 year old could look at this photo and know that this is where their trucks are supposed to go. So use those labels so that everyone can help clean up toys, not just you at the end of the night, but your children, the babysitter. When grandma comes over, everyone can help when things are labeled and organized. Solution number two, let's talk about artwork. This reminds me of a famous organizing mantra which says that if everything is special, nothing is special. Think about it. If you save every drawing, every doodle that your child brings home, starting in preschool until they graduate, that is a lot of paperwork. And when you save everything, it loses the effect of being special. So instead, designate a specific space to display artwork prominently and then stick to that space's boundary limit. Here's one example, a clothesline strung across a wall. You could also use a family room bulletin board. You could have a cork board in their room. You could use the refrigerator if your refrigerator still takes magnets. By having one place to display art, that gives you the important boundary system. So there's a limit to how many pieces of art can be displayed at any one time. And when your child comes home with a new piece of artwork and wants to put it on display, it's with the understanding that something else is going to be retired. And when I say retired, I mean it's going away permanently by either getting recycled or thrown away. Now, your smartphone is one of the greatest organizing tools because oftentimes it's really not the physical item your child has that you're trying to capture the memory of. It's the memory of your child doing that activity or displaying that piece of artwork. So when you're ready to retire one of these pieces of art, take a picture of your child with the piece of art. It's a lot easier and takes up a lot less space to store a digital photo than a piece of artwork. Our third storage solution is regarding jigsaw puzzles. Now, I'm talking about very large jigsaw puzzles of maybe 20, 30, 50, up to 100 pieces. When you bring one of these new puzzles home, before you use it for the first time, pick a color and a shape so that you can label the puzzle and its pieces. So you might make a red circle. You might do a blue triangle. You can get the whole family involved with this if you want, but you're going to label the box cover with your symbol in color, but also with a permanent marker, you're going to mark the back of each piece with the same color and symbol. And that way, if something happens where the puzzle pieces get mixed up with another puzzle, it's easy to figure out where it should return to. Now, even if your box gets damaged over time, you can use its plastic storage bag like a Ziploc bag, and you can store the loose pieces in that bag. And if you do that, just make sure that you put the same colored symbol on the Ziploc bag, so that you know which pieces go to which puzzle. Keep in mind, I am talking about kid-friendly puzzles with a limited number of pieces, not the kind I like to do, where you might have 1,000, 2,000, 5,000 piece puzzle. If you're old enough to work on those bigger puzzles, you should be able to be responsible enough to clean it up properly without needing to have any labeling going on. Our final solution for this video, our fourth one, has to do with Legos. Legos are a brilliant invention. They're so creative. They teach your kids so many great things, including how to follow directions step by step, which is really important when they move out of your house and get their new furniture and need help to assemble it. Well, if they've done Legos their whole childhood, it's going to be a lot easier for them to figure that out. But Legos can also be a source of stress because it is one big pile of clutter with hundreds or thousands of small little bricks in every nook and cranny of your home and always seem to be right where you're stepping with your bare feet. There are all kinds of storage systems that are designed for Legos. There are some specific for Lego. There are some that are just creative. And you can certainly do an internet search and find even more than the three I'm going to talk about on this video. The first one is at the Container Store. They sell storage containers that look like a giant Lego brick, and they come in various colors and sizes. This one happens to be one of the larger ones, an 8-dot Lego brick piece in blue. And you can also use products that aren't specific for Legos, but just happen to work well with them, like tackle boxes or plastic tubs or multi-drawer rolling carts. And you can have all kinds of fun deciding the best way to sort your Legos, from very broad to very elaborate. It's best to get input from your children, but you can sort the pieces by the project. You can sort them by the type of piece they are, or even by color. Whatever is going to make the most sense for the people that are using the Legos. Bags are another option. It is a dual purpose because it gives you a playing surface that has kind of a boundary around it to make it easier for pieces to be self-contained and not be strewn all over the floor, get kicked or something like that under the bed or under the table. But when you're done playing, you can simply cinch up the bag and store it in the corner, or even hang it from a doorknob. Swoop bags come in different sizes and colors. You really just need to go to their website to find out more information. But they've been a very popular option for a lot of my clients. Please visit www.organizingmagic.com for more organizing resources, including our free e-newsletter and information about our monthly Zoom webinars. And remember that new videos drop every Friday. So be in the know, click like and subscribe before you go, so you never miss a single video. I'll see you next time.